So we're in part two of dividing polynomials. In the last video, we mentioned that this is fun because it connects polynomial functions to rational functions. We didn't show how it's going to be helpful yet, but it will. And we started to show how it helps you factor polynomials. So we did here, we factored this completely using division. And in this video, we're going to kind of formally define polynomial division. So this is polynomial division definitions. This will help you. So if you have a polynomial p of x and you divide it by a divisor, so your dividend divided by your divisor, you're always going to get a quotient, which could be a polynomial, plus a remainder, another polynomial, which could be a constant. Remember, a constant is a polynomial, divided by our divisor. And this could be seen even in a really simple case. So example, 41, there's a monomial, very unexciting, divided by 8. Well, the quotient is 5. 8 goes into 41 5 times. So we are counting the quotient as the number of times that 5 goes completely into 41, and in general, the number of times our divisor goes completely into our polynomial. But there's a remainder. There's 5 times 40. 5 times 8 is 40. The remainder is 1 out of 8. So it's 5 and 1/8, and 8 is that divisor. So this definition captures the basic process of what we're doing in long division. That's one way to write it. Another way to write it is to manipulate this here by multiplying both sides by our divisor, by d of x. So I'll show you what I mean. So you have a polynomial divided out by a divisor equals a quotient plus a remainder over our divisor. So if you multiply the right-hand side by your divisor and the left-hand side by your divisor, take a look. Here, on the left-hand side, the divisors cancel, and you're just left with p of x. On the right-hand side, we would distribute d of x to both terms. It cancels in the second term, but in the first term, you would have q of x times d of x plus the remainder. And commonly switch this around by writing the polynomial equals the divisor times the quotient. I tend to write it more this way, plus a remainder of x. It doesn't really matter which order you choose, but the important thing is to recognize that this is another form in which we can write polynomial division, these two things right here, versus this one as well. And as an example, we'll solve a problem, and you'll see how this plays out. Let's say our divisor, our p of x value is, our dividend, our p of x value, our dividend, is 6x squared minus 25x plus 12. And we're dividing it by the divisor x minus 4. So d of x is x minus 4, and the polynomial is 6x squared minus 25x plus 12. So what we do in long division, again, we look at the leading terms. How many times does x go into 6x squared? Divide 6x squared by x, and you get 6x. Then we multiply 6x by our divisor to see if there's anything left over. So we get minus 24x here. Subtract. This is 0. Negative 25x minus negative 24 is negative 25x plus 24, or negative x. And 12 minus nothing is 12. So there's still some left over. And again, we divide these leading terms. Negative x by x is negative 1. And then negative 1 times x minus 4 is negative x plus 4. We subtract to find if there's a remainder. Negative x minus itself is 0. 12 minus 4 is 8. So there is a remainder. And in general here, this is the r value. This is r of x, our remainder. We stop, right? Stop on this line whenever this is a lower degree than the degree of your divisor. This is a 0 degree, right? A constant is a 0 degree. This is a first degree. Whenever this reaches a lower degree than in the divisor, you stop because you're trying to divide and get polynomial functions. If you divide this by, if this is a lower degree, in this case, the 0 power, you divide it by x, you're going to get a negative exponent, which is not a polynomial, would not give you a polynomial result. So the last thing is we have q of x up here. So this is q of x. And we have all the pieces to write this as an answer. So we could say our polynomial function p of x, which was this, divided by x minus 4, the divisor, equals the quotient, so that was 6x minus 1, that's q of x, plus the remainder out of our divisor. If you don't want to write it this way, multiply both sides by x minus 4. On the left-hand side, you get your polynomial function, right, plus 12. And then on the right-hand side, you get x minus 4 times 6x minus 1 plus 8. The x minus 4s cancel, you distribute to both parts. And this shows you that this polynomial function is a product of these two factors plus 8. And if you can test it out, that will work. And these are fitting the two definitions I shared before. And this one right here is the polynomial over the divisor equals the quotient plus the remainder over the divisor. And this one tells us that our polynomial function equals the divisor multiplied by the quotient plus the remainder. And these definitions, going back and forth between them, can be really helpful. All right, thank you.